from politics, security, business, entertainment, and sports stories in less than 4 minutes. You're welcome to RTCV Top 10 News. I am Aisha Jibrin.
The Senate today was in a rowdy session as the senator representing Kogi West Senatorial District, Senator Dino Milai, on the floor of the House raised a motion against the militarization of the 2019 general elections and called for a probe into the process. The Senate has, however, adjourned plenary to April 2nd to allow for seating at committee levels to debate the 2019 appropriation bill. The Federal High Court in Abuja on Wednesday adjourned till Thursday the hearing of the main suit which gave rise to the interlocutory order of the court stopping the Independent National Electoral Commission from continuing with the collation of the March 9, 2018 governorship election in Bauchi State. APC has reacted to the PDP presidential candidate Atiku Abubakar's claim that he won the presidential election with a difference of 1.6 million votes. APC called on INEC and the security agencies to be on red alert to ensure that Atiku and other desperate characters in the PDP are not able to execute their evil plans. The Nigerian Air Force says it will take delivery of Augusta 109 power helicopter from Italy soon to strengthen its arsenal for the fight against insurgency in the northwest. Abubakar said that acquisition of the military helicopter was part of renewed efforts of federal government to ensure that there was security in the northwest. Lagos State governorship candidate in the PDP March 9 election, Jimmy Agbaji, says there's no truth in the report that he had left the party. He attributed insinuations that he had dumped PDP to mischief makers determined to soil his reputation, provoke crisis within the party, and dampen the spirit of party members and his supporters. The Indian High Commissioner to Nigeria, Abba Taku, says his country would support Nigeria in tackling security challenges. He stated this when he visited the Chief of Army Staff at the Army headquarters of Abuja. Taku admitted that Nigeria and India had similar security challenges, especially terrorism. As Nigeria joins the world to celebrate Water Day, findings have revealed that 69 million Nigerians of the population have no access to safe water, while less than 1 in 10, which is 9.2% of households, drink safe water. The National Bureau of Statistics said the number of registered workers under the pension scheme in the fourth quarter, 8.1 million registered workers in the second quarter 2018. The Bureau said that the pension fund asset under management as at fourth quarter 2018 stood at 8.6 million as against 8.3 million in the second quarter 2018. American singer Tamar Braxton has expressed interest in working with Afropop star Davido in his upcoming album. Braxton reached out to Davido's team through an Instagram comment on his international manager's Ife Ogbeni's page. Organizers of the Tokyo 2020 Olympics on Wednesday unveiled a cherry blossom-shaped torch for the Games as the city prepares for the famed flower season to begin in coming days. The top part of the torch is shaped in the traditional emblem of the sakura, a cherry blossom using the same cutting-edge technology as in production of Japan's bullet trains.
For more news updates, follow social media handles as displayed on your screen. And that's the RTCV Top 10 News today. I am Aisha Jibrin.